We're out of luck today. We got caught in the rain. We won't make it in time for the service. Well, they will have to bear with us.
A parish Evangelical Lutheran Church opened here at the very beginning of the 90s. We called it Bible Church and then Bible Lutheran Church. In due time, other congregations and missions appeared in different parts of Siberia, in Khakassia, Buryatia, and so forth. It became quite obvious that there was a need to offer theological education to the people who work and serve there, and to the missionaries who are getting ready to organize new missions, as well as to the missionaries and pastors already involved in this work.
We have a very big territory here, and distance between our missions are 3,000 miles. We have just 7 priests for all this territory, and so we need to travel a lot every time. It is very difficult. Also, we understand that church doesn't have future without seminary. Church needs to have new priests, new pastors.
There was a nucleus of strong, young Lutheran leadership, and we had come to know of this leadership, and was asked whether we could assist this leadership in opening a school for the training of church workers and especially pastors to serve the Lutheran Church in this part of the world and to extend the preaching of the gospel in Siberia as well as elsewhere.
We realize that we have resources that that a small church or a younger church does not have, and that there's a certain obligation to share these.
While I was still a first-year student at the seminary in Fort Wayne, suddenly they begin to be talk about the possibility of starting a seminary in Novosibirsk. And I was amazed that while I thought and prayed and told myself that it would be good to open an educational institution, ideally a seminary in Novosibirsk, I never knew it was going to happen so quickly.
Oh, there certainly was a sense of apprehension and anxiety, especially the first time, because we really didn't know what we were doing. we came really, you know, not having a sense of what to expect.
One of the challenges is that we don't know Russia, but we do know Lutheran theology and the Lutheran tradition. And the challenge would be for men who are young, for many who are rather new to the faith, to be able to translate the theology into practice. Practice which is clearly Russian and suitable for a Russian Lutheran church, and it's a big task.
This crucifix. We present to you the West Siberian Christian Mission,
Западно-Сибирской христианской миссии,
this building.
The academic year was supposed to begin on September 1, but in fact it did not start on this day, since the building was not ready yet. They promised that it would be ready by October 1, but it was not ready by then either. We could no longer postpone the beginning of the academic year, and so we had to rent an apartment. There we began studies. And we were glad to find six people, because then it was quite a challenge to look for candidates to study at the seminary, which actually did not exist yet.
I sat on the couch and I didn't have a desk to write in, to write on it. So it was fun. And we also had to make about 15-minute trip from the place where we lived to the place where we studied. And but the nice thing about it, it was that the atmosphere there was very, it was a family atmosphere. And I think that is the thing that I appreciate most.
The first year it was a Siberian seminary. The emphasis will always be on Siberia, east towards the Far East, and maybe west as far as Ekaterinburg. But already, through the outreach of the church, through your website, through your missionary trips, through Good News Magazine and Christian literature distribution, more and more people are finding that there's no seminary like this in the former Soviet Union. There are many seminaries, many where they have to study 2 weeks at a time, but there's not one seminary where the students come and stay in residence and study with the same rigor for a four-year program that they have here. And there are people, many non-Lutheran Christians, who have come to the faith and then discovered Lutheranism, and they see this as a place to come.
Every summer, seminars are conducted with the participation of Missouri Synod professors, in particular men from the Fort Wayne Seminary. The seminars are there, many people get interested in seminary in Novosibirsk. They ask questions. Through the summer seminars, we have found many of our students who have come from far away. This is a very good means to recruit prospective students.
For the most part, these are men from Russia, from different cities, from Sakhalin to Saratov. We have one man from the Ukraine and people from Kazakhstan. I am from Kyrgyzstan. I studied in Kazakhstan under Bishop Moser, taking courses offered for junior pastors. Even then, I had heard about the Lutheran seminary in Novosibirsk.
And I had a desire for a long time to study for the ministry, to become a theologian, and then to serve as a pastor in the Ukraine.
Having gathered my last money, I purchased a ticket. Before that, I got in touch with the rector, Reverend Strelsov, and he said, "Come, we'll be glad to have you."
I was a week late. The classes had already begun, and in Hebrew had already started. This is a certainly very unusual language, so it was surely hard in the beginning.
I had already done service in the church. On the whole, I knew what it was. I expected it to be a painstaking labor, but I did not think it would be so intense.
Judging by the studies and by the fact that I finish sometimes at 2 a.m. or 3 a.m., I see that it's a serious thing.
The cold was a problem. I got my ears frostbitten at times. It was a little difficult in the beginning, but now it's normal. To a certain extent, I even do not want to go back home, because at home there is a rain, not snow. But I think rain, oops, I mean snow, is better in winter.
From the very first seminar we taught, we recognized that there was something about the students that we had not experienced among our own students in Fort Wayne. There is an eagerness for the gospel. There is a joy of studying the scriptures and hearing the good news and absorbing it, and for many, I think for the first time, hearing it explained in ways that they have not heard it before.
The Russian theological student is more quickly adapt in learning theology than the American counterpart is. I think that depends a great deal on the fact that the Russian mind tends to be more philosophical, much more aware of history.
I think it's a similar situation to grandparents and aunts and uncles who see the children for a short time and they say, oh, how wonderful, what well-behaved children you have. I'm very impressed with your children. And then I'm like the father who has these children all the time, and I know them perhaps better than some of the visitors. I also perhaps love them more for this reason.
Alexei Streltsov suggested the need for a full-time professor. It is not a suggestion we made. And when I asked him, well, do you have any suggestions? Right away he recommended Alan Ludwig.
Reverend Ludwig has the qualities of a real missionary that are sometimes absent in the people who came from America as professional missionaries. In this case, it was clearly our initiative. We invited Reverend Ludwig to teach here, to prepare pastors for our church.
I watched them grow as theologians and as persons. This is very satisfying to see them change, to see the Word of God mold them, to see them begin to think in good theological ways, to begin to apply this theology to their own lives, to the world around them. There come opportunities in these close conditions with other students, especially with many students in a fairly small facility, to practice Christian charity and patience and forgiveness. So I think there is plenty of opportunity to apply what they learn in the seminary to their daily lives. And I think most of the professors who come, and certainly I, try to make a bridge from the theoretical knowledge to the practical application of this, not only in their ministry, but also in their Christian life.
It's certainly significant that the center room in this entire building is the chapel. And the fact that in this, you know, place, people come together once a day to pray and once a week to celebrate the Eucharist is a foundational way in which this community is constituted. And I think the fact that they live together, they study together, they eat together, creates a sense of community and camaraderie that will help them during those times when things aren't as good.
When students say that maybe they can't be pastors because they don't have good powers and they are not good enough for this ministry, I am glad to hear this because it means that they are thinking about this ministry. It means that they are very serious about this ministry.
Это кровь Иисуса Христа.
Аминь.
И восставление твоих грехов. Это кровь Иисуса Христа.
Аминь.
И восставление твоих грехов.
A seminary is not a university. It doesn't exist simply to impart theological knowledge. It exists to impart theological understanding for the purpose of assisting the church, especially here by way of pastoral training.
Many of the men that come here and teach are not on the faculty of the seminary, but they are parish pastors who have completed doctoral degrees and are fully capable of being on our faculty.
And it helps that they say things that are very pertinent for practical work in the parish. We have a whole year of internship in the parish, that is, vicarage in our program. At the same time, we offer opportunities for our students to do some practical work serving in the church during every vacation. It may be assisting a certain pastor in the parish or some independent activity. It is not a mandatory part of our program, that is, we don't require it from students. But such possibilities are always there, and practically all of the students take advantage of them. Especially in the summer, students do things in the church.
Father Alexei asked me before the practical, where would you like to be? Somebody wanted to be in Tomsk, somebody elsewhere, but I did not want any other place. In other words, I did not answer that question, because I had fallen in love with Hakasia in the winter. And even before this, I had asked Pastor Pavel to take me. I knew beforehand where I would have my practical. The church here in Tuim is situated in the former town hall. This was a state institution that resolved all kinds of questions. Now there is church here. And it was here that I began to understand more what it means to follow Christ. It is in these remotest places that you understand that you simply have to help. Any time of the day or night, regardless, the door is open, just knock.
В Томске я с 1 июля общину,
которая I have been in Tomsk since July 1st. We hold studies here. The congregation of the West Siberian Christian Mission here is quite small, and the more so because it is summer now. The season of vacations and leaves. The young people have gone home. Our second field is the local LCRAS church, which asked us to conduct Bible studies and to preach in Russian on Sundays. And also we meet with people at the homeless shelter that was opened here in Tomsk with assistance from the Lutheran church. There we conduct studies and also we come on Sundays and do a little evening prayer service. We give the sermon there also. It is simplified, for the people here are uneducated. They are in such a condition that they ask very serious questions. And most important, one sees such as a big interest in their eyes. There are things that were not in the foreground for me, but now I can ponder on them. I have to read the Church Fathers and Christian dogmatics more and repeat some things there and look for answers to people's questions.
I want to sleep as little as possible, to eat as little as possible, only to work, even though it may not be called work. And once you encounter such situations, you want to study further to know more. In Kirovo, the congregation is young, very young. That is, it consists of children. There is pandemic drunkenness in the village. Adults do not go to church. They come, listen, and leave. But children come, they are confirmed, they receive communion. When I see these children, a question arises that answers itself. Are you needed?
Yes, needed. Right here.
I think that there is an opportunity here for the preaching of the gospel that has made possible this extraordinary effort here in theological education. I think this is going to be one of the most exciting things that I will ever be a part of in my life. It's not only encouraging, but it's invigorating for us. It's a very vital learning experience.
We have been wholly gratified by the progress made thus far.
We simply did not anticipate having such a large number of people that our current building would be not adequate for them.
So it's proper to call Lutheran Theological Seminary an international seminary. It sounds a little pompous, but it's just true. And no one could have expected it.
Now we face new thrilling possibilities. We are ready to reach a new level, to move to the new building in Academ Gordok. There we will have a seminary with a capital S, so to speak, a real educational institution. We will have access to greater opportunities there. For instance, Novosibirsk State University professors will conceivably give some courses in the broad liberal arts area at the pre-seminary level. There will be many more possibilities for organizing the library. Possibly, we will turn it into an open library for everybody. There will simply be nicer conditions in the new building. Formerly, it was a building of the Siberian Bank. This is very interesting. Sometimes I contemplate this. Time will tell. It seems to me that a seminary is also a bank of the kind, but it has totally different character.
So we recognize that a seminary doesn't exist on its own. It exists as the educational wing, if you will, of a church for the training of its own workers. And so I'll summarize by mentioning three things for the future. The development of the church in this place, the development then of the seminary, both in its teaching staff as well as in its student population. This is the three-pronged progress that we hope and expect will take place in the future.
Семинария для нас это наше христианское свидетельство.
For us, the seminary, this is our Christian witness, and we've got an opportunity to teach the Word of God and to teach the doctrine of the Christian Church correctly. I hope, therefore, that is our obligation to use this opportunity and let people hear this and consequently go back to their parishes and properly teach there.
Читаются от священного писания и от лютеранских исповедных книг. И поэтому я считаю, что наш долг этой возможностью пользоваться и позволять людям слышать это и соответственно возвращаться в свои приходы и служить там и правильно учить так как нужно.